Hey, so we're here at my Aunt Deb's house. We're gonna talk with Aunt Deb about my song Make It to Tomorrow because Aunt Deb is a licensed mental health professional. And so I've just been curious about like what her reactions and thoughts are around the song. So we're gonna chat. I get so many dumb questions about being a person living with CPTSD
Yes.
and depression. You know, I might be dating someone and they see me take my meds in the morning
Right.
and they go, "What happens if you don't take your meds? Will you kill me?"
Wow.
And I'm like,
Wow.
no.
Right. That you would go there.
unlikely, but that's what people think, you
Right.
know? And so I wonder, I don't know, like, why do we have such a hard time with just saying,
Yeah.
like, life is not easy for me.
Yes.
You know, I'm
Whew.
having a hard time.
Right.
Sometimes I don't think I even want to be here anymore.
Right.
You know, I don't know if I want to go to therapy because then I'm crazy, you
Right.
know, all that
Right.
kind of
Right.
thing.
Two things. I want to go just back briefly to the happiness of the
Sorry.
first line. No, but the thought that came to me was there is this juxtaposition of the
Yeah.
light comedic artist Stitch, who recently passed away.
Yeah.
Life, music, joy, full of that.
Yeah.
And so if you see that person, he's embodied with joy. And with that joy, subtext, sometimes I feel suicidal. And that's a message that people can't see together.
Yeah.
So that's interesting how just that combination of what people see and go, how could that possibly have been?
Yeah.
They were so happy.
You'd have never
They were
guessed.
so jo- You never guessed. They were so joyful. And so to have those two things together, joy and the possibility of ending my life.
Yeah.
And so I think it's a conversation,
Wow.
right?
I didn't make that connection.
Until you said that,
I didn't
I
make that
thought,
connection, but when you think about the music in itself, it's like think about like Robin Williams and all these other people who you're like,
that's right.
these people, like depression looks so many different ways.
Yes.
And you wouldn't be able to tell.
Right.
So in a way, like the case of the song is like this joyful music,
Yes.
but if you listen,
They're embodying this, and folks feel safe, like they're safe. This person's nowhere near thinking about this because they're over here on the joy spectrum, if there's a spectrum to be had. So I think that was the first thing. That just kind of reminded me of that sort of combination. The other around the Black experience. And I think, and I've seen this before too, in our history, our ancestors, so much of this sort of issue of how we care for ourselves. First, it was in the church. I have Jesus. My pastor's gonna pray this way. We're gonna sing this way. We're going to be in community. And for some seasons, yes, that did work. Coming together, saying it out loud, some elements of that were healing, some aspects were. Did have result, and there were lots of people, throughout history who we just gave names for what they were going through. We just gave some context, whether it was, oh, they may be demonically possessed, or they're, so we hide that, we don't talk about it. We put it under the rug. I think presently, currently, there's a sense in which I'm not in control if I go to a therapist. I'm not pulling my weight. It has this sense of that's for folks who are, they're crazy or they're beyond control or there's something that will minimize me so greatly if I admit that I need help. If I admit that all this resilience, all this history of being able to take care of myself, and that's been true. And there are ways in which this new understanding around there's more to this than just having a bad day, just going to a church service, just even going for a walk. All things may be great in and of themselves, but it's not the whole picture. It's not the whole picture. And folks having this sense of recognizing that, I mean, I don't want to keep using your phrase, but it's true.
It doesn't have to
It
be
doesn't
this
have to be this way,
way.
and that's what I plead with people, friends, family members who have dealt with and are dealing with traumas, mm-hmm. you know, the trauma in my own history and past, and the ways in which it's been unpacked because of therapy. Other folks have used and had medication to help this. But just having the conversation, to have people who are in places of either respect or leadership or are seen as insightful, to include mental health as a normative part of everyday. Saying, oh my goodness, yeah, that's a part of what I do.